Let us close the eyes. Praying to God and all the masters. Om Sahana Vavatu, Sahanau Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavadhitamastu, Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shantihi, Shantihi, Shantihi. May God protect us all. May we enjoy food together. May we meditate and pray together. May we attain wisdom through our study and discussion. May there be no conflict among us. Om. Amen. I bow to one God who is formless, omnipresent. I bow to all the masters of Kriya Yoga lineage. Humbly I bow to all the saints and sages of all times and places. Humbly I bow to each one of you. You are the living power of God. Good morning for USA. Good morning for Canada and South American countries. Good evening to some places. Good afternoon to some places. I'm really happy to see all of you. Today is the most auspicious day in India. We have begun the 9 days worship of Divine Mother Durga, who gives us strength, who removes all the difficulties from our life, who removes all the sufferings. I just finished my personal puja with all the residents, a little fire ceremony, and just joined this session. We all are passing through a difficult time at present, when there is threat of this pandemic, coronavirus. Throughout the world, people are suffering. There's chaos. And we hear a lot of people are telling that they are panicked. They are feeling a lot of fear, which is natural in such a difficult situation. However, today we are beginning this discourse because we are not having any program for coming month, even up to April end. We have canceled all our programs. We also have canceled our group meditations in many places because of the current situation. So we thought that it will be a good idea that we reach out to you and we still can have some satsang, some discourse, as well as some meditation, because this is the time when we have to keep our strength on its peak. Well, today, because of a lot of fear, I'm going to talk a little bit about this problem of fear in our life. So I'll just share some of the slides with you. There is a beautiful book, Freedom from Fear, Guruji has written. So some essence of this book I will share with you, which is very relevant in today's difficult circumstances. We all are having some fear, no doubt. But what is fear? If you understand this, then we can overcome this. To define fear, there are a few ways I can tell you some definition. First thing, that if we take fear in a negative sense, then it means forget everything and run. Just imagine when you get this fear, what happens? You forget everything and just you want to run away from that situation or person or whatever is creating fear. You want to run away. If we take this positively, then fear means face everything and rise. These two definitions have come from these letters, fear, F-E-A-R. So face everything and rise. Now, what is fear? Fear means false evidence appearing real. That means there is no reality, but it appears as real, just like ignorance or Maya, cosmic illusion force. So also fear, most of the time our fears are imaginary fear. Very few cases may be there where real fear is there, but most of the time because of our imagination, we bring fear. What is fear? Fear is just a natural emotion. As we are human being, we have different emotions. So also one of the emotion is fear. Now, further, if you want to analyze, I want to share with you Sage Bhartrahari, long back in India, who was a king, then he became a monk. He wrote 100 verses on Vairagya or dispassion. So in one of the verse 31, Vairagya Shatakam, he wrote that everything in this world is associated with fear. Whether it is family reputation, or it is wealth, or it is prestige, beauty, power, or even knowledge. So anything we have, it is always associated with fear. But when we have detachment, we are little having dispassion, then we can become from completely free from fear. And Guruji says that be a yogi, because yogi has no fear. Yogi means one who is always united with God in every action, in every breath. So he has no fear. There are different types of fear in our life. And you can find in this book, Freedom from Fear, a list of different fears. But I will just tell you three main fears in our life. One fear is loss of happiness. It happens very often that we are peaceful. We have many beautiful different places, or we have so many different types of activities, and we feel happy. So when we are very happy, there is a fear, we don't want to lose happiness. Even when we are in the nice deep meditation, we don't want to lose that blissful state. Another fear comes into life, that is loss of someone or something. Loss of someone or something. We have a friend. We have family members. We love someone. And with that, this fear comes that maybe I may lose this person. I may lose my friend. Or you like something very much, and fear comes that I don't want to lose it. Maybe I may lose it. But the biggest of these fears is the fear of death. Nobody wants to die. Everybody wants to live. Nobody wants to go away. And fear of death is the main fear in our life. And if you see in the current situation, what is happening? That there is problem. There is difficulty because of this coronavirus situation. People are dying every day. And it is sad. I'm really praying for all. But what to do? When there is death, we have to be careful that I should not follow wrong lifestyle, and I should take complete care for my body, my mind. So when there's death, we see death, and also this fear comes that maybe I may die tomorrow. It may be my number. So the fear of death is there. But let me tell you, there's a beautiful story Paramahansa Yoganandaji had shared in one of his books. He told that there was a monk, and he was in deep meditation. While meditating, he had a vision that some ghost was appearing. So he asked this ghost, "Who are you and what are you doing here?" So Ghost told that I am here because Lord has commanded me to enter your village and take lives of three people. So I have come here to kill three people. So the monk said that you cannot kill because this is the village where I am living and people are following righteous lifestyle. So you should not be here. But the ghost told that I just follow the command of Lord. So I had to come here and I will take the life of only three people. However, sage was not happy, but he had to obey the command of Lord. So he said, okay, just three people you can kill. And then he went to his meditation. Next day in the village, three people died. And after that, in coming few days, lots of people died. Then sage meditated because he was unhappy. When he meditated, he invoked this ghost and ghost appeared. So monk asked him, you had promised me that you would take life of only three people, but why so many people are dying? Why did you lie? So ghost told that I never lied to you. It is because of the fear. He said that I took life of only three people, but rest of the people are dying because of fear. And this is what happens in life, that looking at other things, we become fearful. So we should be strong enough. What is the cause of fear? I'll just tell you. There are two main causes. One is ignorance, other is attachment and insecurity. Ignorance, that we are immortal soul, we are not body, but because we forget it, and that's why we become fearful. And attachment to the body also brings more body consciousness and it brings insecurity. And that again leads us to a state of fear. However, what to do with this fear? In short, Guruji has recommended three things. Develop confidence, means don't become weak. Feel that you are powerful, you are strong enough, because everything is guided by our mind. Mind is very powerful instrument, and if we guide our mind in positive direction, we become positive. If it is guided or it is leading us in a negative channel, then we start thinking negative and we become not only fearful, but we invite more troubles in our life. So be confident. Second thing Guruji says, trust in God. Trust in God means, remember, one who has sent us in this beautiful world, he is going to take care of us. Of course, here I want to clarify one thing, that trust in God does not mean that we just sit with closed eyes and think that God is going to come and save me. No, God has given us intellect. God also has given us all the different types of facilities. For example, God has given us God. God has given us doctors. God also has provided us medicine. God also gave us our family member to care, take care of us. So we need to consult the doctor. We need to take medicine if needed. We also may need to follow all the rules or laws by which we are abide. Never think that just trusting in God and not doing anything is going to save us. Trust God in God means we have to trust the God who is in front of us in the form of doctor, in the form of family member, in the form of medicine. Everything is God. And third thing is be content. So don't be greedy. Be content. It will save you. How to become free from fear? In short, I can tell you, always remember that your real nature is not the nature of anger, fear, frustration. But your real nature is you are the soul, immortal soul. And the quality of soul is Sat, Chit and Ananda. So what is Sat, Chit, Ananda? Sat means eternity. Chit means knowledge or consciousness. And Ananda means bliss. Now these three things, if we remember and we are established in our true nature through contemplation, through meditation, then we can overcome these three great fears in our life, which we discussed. What is eternity? As a soul, I am always there. Soul has no death. There is death for body, and death is nothing. It is just transition from one life to other life. And in between, there is a little pause. So we are eternal soul. Nobody can kill us. Nobody, and soul is free from suffering. And second thing, chit, consciousness. As a soul, we are always conscious. So if we have knowledge, if we are conscious, then how ignorance can touch us? So there should be no ignorance, because we know our real nature. And third is ananda or bliss. Our nature is not frustration. Our nature is not worry. Our nature is not anxiety. Our nature is nature of bliss, ananda. So that is our true nature. So once we contemplate and remember that I am the soul, eternal soul, so I will never be unhappy, I will never feel ignorant, and I will always feel that I am immortal soul. So this is how we have to think about it. Yes, there is difficulty in present time, but we need to be strong. I remember as a child, I had some fear. Even street dogs following me. And once it happened that one street dog was creating trouble for me. So I was so fearful that I ran away. Then I think I was just 5 years old at that time. So my mother had recommended that whenever you feel any fear, you can chant a mantra. So mantra is nothing but it works on this sound energy. And when I started chanting the mantra, two things happened. One thing, because of the faith, I really felt so strong and protected. And it happened that completely I became free from fear just in the few months' time. And since then I learned, as Yogananji also has taught the same thing, that if we are fearful, then fear follows us. But once we start facing it, then everything goes. So I had no fear since then. Chanting mantra is good. Also, meditation is the best way. So we all should meditate. And meditation will give us inner strength to face this difficult situation. We all are together. So we will overcome this temporary phase of this difficulty. Maybe 2 weeks, 3 weeks, maybe a couple of weeks. But don't worry. We all are together and we all are praying for all of you. Every day, Guruji, every day, we all residents are praying for everyone. We all will be better and better. It is just a temporary phase. And in case you feel any difficulty, you feel any problem, any question, always feel free to reach us. Because now we cannot communicate personally, but at least this technology has made it possible. So feel free, if you need any help from us, you're always here. Just to tell you, yesterday, day before yesterday night, I think, in India, there is complete lockdown. So yesterday, I asked my friend in India that how do you feel now? What is the situation? And, you know, he sent me this nice picture, and he sent me this video, and he said, you know, if I stay longer at home like this lockdown situation, then I will be like this. Remember, any situation, any difficulty, we should keep our moral high, our strength, and we should always be cheerful. I am with all of you. I don't want to talk too much about fear or anything. Let us be peaceful, be more divine. Let us meditate. We will pray to God for the whole world. We'll chant Mahamrityunjaya mantra to make people free from suffering, free from fear and all difficulties. Om. त्रयंबकं यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उर्वारुकमिव बंधनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षीयमामृतात्। ॐ त्रयंबकं यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उर्वारुकमिव बंधनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षीयमामृतात्। ॐ त्रयंबकं यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उर्वारुकमिव बंधनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षीयमामृतात्। ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। Let us be peaceful, calm. Let us extend this peace in our family, all around us, and in the whole cosmos. Let all become happy and healthy, loving, noble, and generous. Let there be no suffering or sorrow. Let there be no disease. Let there be peace, purity, perfection, harmony, love among us and in this whole creation. May the blessings of God and the masters be upon us all and everywhere. Om. Amen. Remember, in life, nothing is permanent. One breath, which is going in, is also coming out. Every inhalation is life. So whatever circumstances are there, it will definitely change. Let us increase our inner strength through regular meditation. Let us keep a prayerful attitude. I am praying for all of you, praying for the whole world. Let us be free from all this fear, from disease. And again, we'll come to happy, blissful life. So keep in touch. Any problem, if you feel, you're welcome to contact us through emails, phone calls, or messages. Thank you all for joining us. I'm happy to meditate with all of you wherever we are. Follow the local guidelines from the local government. Follow the hygienic rules. Trust in God. This shall too pass away. Thank you all. And we will be again having next satsang and meditation session on this coming Sunday. So hope to see you again. Meditate every day. Thank you all.